From exceeding on the silver screen at a small price to succeeding here, like pumpkin blowing party. My mind. I mean, this is a pumpkin Picasso, and you've earned that name, man,
it's
because
Tim
this is awesome.
Parkey, yeah. And he's actually a friend of one of our dear crew members here.
Yeah. Actually, the guy behind the camera. Yeah. That's your son-in-law there, so make him proud, Chris.
All right, so tell us what you're doing. A potato peeler.
Potato peeler is how you can change just a typical triangle pumpkin. You can just put your, do this.
You.
Kids won't get hurt because it's not sharp, too sharp.
Well, so they can help out, too.
They can definitely do this.
So how long does it take you to do a pumpkin like this normally? I know you're kind of rushing here for our show, but...
This is 4 and a half hours so far. So my longest is 14 hours. My masterpieces are 10 to 12 hours.
Fantastic.
And so...
What about the one at Disneyland? Tell us about that. You did this massive pumpkin.
You were asked by Disney.
I was asked by Disney. Did two pumpkins. One a 381-pound anatomically correct crocodile, because you can't have an alligator with Captain Hook, and a 624-pound hippopotamus.
Oh, my goodness.
And it was on a bale of hay, and I had to do this to sculpt it, and I had just these tools, and I realized I was a little bit outweighed by trying
I'm sure that took you longer than 4 hours.
Did you do it live for folks that were at the park, or did you do it, did they want it completed when
no,
it was?
No. It was, I was right in front of the castle, and people were gathering around me all the time.
Awesome.
So it was great to
have. How did they find out about you?
I happen to send them a couple 8x10 glossies of my work.
There you go. Very nice. They're promoting yourself. Who's
going
to do a better job than you?
That's right.
Hey, so can somebody do something similar, or does this take a lot of training, or could you do something pretty simple?
You could do simple. I mean, I started with slash and gash, just a potato peeler, the melon ball scoop, and a beer can opener. And if you want to do scratches like this, I mean, you could just...
You're attacking the pumpkin.
And it looks kind of ragged.
It looks pretty good. If you want to do some, I don't want to do it on you. There we go.
But all right. Like Tim Parkney, thanks for joining us.
We'll check back with you, man.
Okay.
Appreciate it. Thank you so much.
Fist bump.
There you go.